All right there, my name's Ragtag, and I'm the greatest gutter to your gamer on the face of this earth, and today, I'm gonna shower the losers of this world with knowledge, give you all some beautiful pieces of advice that you're gonna need to survive the perils of this battle royale in 2020, because the longer a game has been out, the higher the average skill of the player base, and the more reason that you don't want left behind feeling the pangs of regret that you had to change to another game because your uselessness is going to get tolerated on the next PvP shooter game. That is until everyone gets the better of you on that one and this cycle continues. Now, I don't buy into the idea of regret or I wish I could have changed any of my gutter tier moments in the past, and you know why? Because I want life to kick me in the plums now and again. It's how we get better. Some of us need more groin stomps than others, I'll give you that, but that's alright. That's why you're here. For those of you who have been a long time subscriber, you're going to have noticed a marked increase in my own skill level. And while of course it would be easy to put that down to just simply playing the game, and it does a little bit, but I'm probably one of the most casual players in the Apex Legends content creating world. Maybe I play 1 or 2 hours a day, sometimes more, but sometimes not at all, as I have other games I'm interested in as well, and yes, they might be shooters, but still, I didn't improve in the usual route, but I have gotten a lot better since March, and you only need to watch some of my first videos on Apex to see that my gameplay resembled, well, someone who'd rigged up a monitor display to look like a carnival funhouse wall of mirrors. I was getting bamboozled by my own shadow, but we're not here to talk about me, we're bringing it over to you. You're here because you suck. You are the stone in the shoes of your teammates. You're about as useful as a white crane, and you know that if you keeled over and died tomorrow, your girlfriend would bring a date to your funeral. So let's give you 10 tips to quickly catch you up so you can power walk to the top of the sludge pile and be the king of the shite. Number one, if it weren't for my teammates, I'd be Apex. Better shut your mouth, bitch. This is deflective, ego-saving nonsense that that little monkey on your shoulder tells you so that you can proudly play Apex with a rationalized process for why you lost the last 50 games. Ask yourself this, ever made a mistake? Fell off the high ground, whiffed an entire level 3 extended heavy mag of your prowler with select fire on it, and then you die. But then afterwards your teammates, they follow shortly afterwards. Of course, your teammates watched you fall and left you to die, or you missed all of your shots with the prowler, but then you say, hang on a minute, where was my backup? Why did you miss your shots? We can't both be missing every shot here. How bad are you? Welcome to Loserville. That is a prison created by your own mind. Number two, perspective. What you see is what you see, and you're convinced that you're right. You should have gone left, should have targeted Wraith. We could have avoided the other team if only we blah, 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 blah. Well, guess what? You're wrong. You don't know a goddamn thing, and you don't have a 360-degree view of the battlefield. What you do have is a guess, and that's all it is. We love to assume that we're right and we've got the full answer because that's how it works in the brain of an idiot. Your teammate is 20 yards east, the other one's a bit further forward. What about their decision making, their reactions, their thoughts on what is right? That doesn't matter because they're useless, right? Wrong, dickhead. Chill out on the blame front and remember that everything you think you know about a situation, well, that is based only upon what you could see at any particular time. And once you can do this, you will overcome a particular part of the stubbornness to learn. I tell my friends to get fucked all the time if they give me any kind of you should have done this. Why? Did you see what I saw? No. Shut your goddamn mouth before I slap the lips off your face because I didn't order a glass of your opinion, bitch. Number three, gratitude. Now the previous 2 points should already be giving you pause for reflection right now for how to proceed because all I've been doing is ripping apart your sense of identity and reasons why you've lost most of your games so far and so I would say right now is a good time to reframe the unfortunate situations where you felt abandoned, betrayed, and whatever other nonsense you conjured up in post-rationalization, yeah, all that stuff. Let's reframe it to an Eastern philosophy interpreted specifically for Apex Legends. A lot of the principles of being happier in an increasingly busy world are just as important now as they were 1,000 years ago, and that is expressing that gratitude. And let's be grateful for what we do well. Wow, I survived that fight after jumping around accidentally meleeing the air because my fingers suddenly contracted some kind of frostbite. Thank you for allowing me another chance to prove how shite I am at this game. Or when it comes to your teammates, say, hey, thank you for leaving my side when I was alone and surrounded by enemies and you decided to duck out and leave me 1v3. I realized just how much I was actually able to do without you, you absolute prickaloids. Number four, simple game theory. One of the most important rules in Overwatch for ranking up was always to simplify those goals, and if you wanted to rank up as like a silver player, All you'd have to do to actually climb would be play like a gold player consistently, and those dreams would come true. And it's the same for Apex. If you feel an advantage over an enemy in a particular situation and it's working, you keep doing it. And if they're dumb enough to fall into the same trap, let them. When people start attempting brazen trickery instead of doing what they know is getting the job done, it's ridiculous. You don't have to sacrifice position if you've got a clear line of sight and your shots are hitting your mark. You don't need to perform a finisher on a downed enemy in the middle of a cockfight. You don't need to do a great many things other than what you feel is in the power of your loins and it's dominating the enemy. Anything more than that is pushing your luck. And I like to think your bad luck is probably like mine. Impossible to underestimate. Number 5. Decisions, decisions, decisions. What separates me now from my former self is that I make a lot more decisions than I did when I was first playing this game. But the first step to making better decisions is not to do too many 180s. And a perfect example of this is applicable on the Winter Express event. When you feel incoming grenades invading the carriage you're inside, do you go outside through the front, move backwards, round the pillar, slip out the side door? Many people do a little bit of everything before they actually make a final decision, and I say bollocks to it. Just get used to reacting with your gut and go with it. Sometimes you'll regret not taking a moment just to think about it for a half second, but we have to get you used to being more decisive. And bear in mind that when an enemy throws in one grenade from outside, chances are they're going to throw in another. So sometimes the closer you are to danger, the further you are from harm, because you might be the one with the gun against an empty hand. Number 6. Figure out the fear. I don't know about you, but I've been finding whenever I've got the P2020 with the hammer point hop up, quite often, if my opponents are platting below, they shite themselves with the sound of that gun and they start running away against my pea shooter. Now they can have purple armor, fully charged, and I watch them dive for cover until they gather themselves and realize that their R99 is actually going to do the job. And why? Because the sound of the P2020 coupled with a fire rate is terrifying to them. And it's the same for many with the wingman. It makes a big bang. And while many will claim they're not scared, the strafing or the mistakes that your enemies make whilst they're facing off against it, that can tell a different story. If you find that a particular weapon has ingrained some kind of painful memory from your history, times perhaps when you felt so utterly destroyed that the testosterone was leaking out your sack in shame, then we have to get you a friend in the firing range to shoot it at you time and time again until the very sound of that gun sets you free. Number 7. Face your uselessness. Once you've figured out what enemy weapons are putting you off your game, it's time to find out what else is going on inside those rusted, fossilized cogs of your brain. For example, where you land in a map, or there's lots of other things that can just set off a more primal survival instinct inside of you. It needs overcome in a rational way, and the best way to do that is tackle it head on. If you die every time you're using the wingman, then take nothing but the wingman. If you die every time you drop at Skyhook, then drop nowhere but Skyhook. I think I've mentioned this particular thing before, but many moons ago, I took my degree in music, and singing was my thing. Every time I came to bars of music that required vocal acrobatics or high notes, I shat myself and I fell flat on my face. And in fact, the higher I sang, the worse it got, and I could see despair on my singing teacher's face. So, I spent 80% of my practice doing what I was worst at, and after a while, everyone I would meet would be starting to call me naturally gifted at fast passages and songs with soaring high notes. It wasn't a natural gift. I fucking sucked at it. I just hated sucking at it more, so I grabbed it by the nutsack and I got those notes out. Number 8. Energy control. The problem with slow, wind-up games in Apex Legends is that the comfort levels of combat have to be in such a particular place for them to succeed that when you step into ranked and someone types right at the beginning, "Oh, let's camp," my heart instantly sinks. And the reason for that is I'm just not wired to deal with the mindset of running away like a little bitch. I prefer to hunt and third party if necessary and engage every opportunity to upgrade my loadout and gain RP aggressively. If you don't play Apex like this, that's fine, but your comfort levels in suddenly springing to life after doing very little all game, they have to be controlled bursts of energy, and in my experience, almost all of the campy, slow, wind-up teammates I've come across, they've been shite. A few were good, don't get me wrong, but when tested, campers and people who run away a lot, they often whiff a lot worse than I ever do, because their energy has spiked when they were unprepared. You know, if they mistimed a third party opening shots, it threw them for the rest of the fight. So if you insist on being the slow wind-up gamer, the best thing I can say to you would be ease off on the electric shock on your right hand of your controller when you're looking around. It's your mouse hand as well. Or when it comes to the left hand, that's all right. That can take the brunt of that spike. For everyone else who goes on the hunt and likes to look for fights, it's just about making sure you don't get too tightly wound up that you snap when you finally engage. Number 9, fail better. I know this is coming in at number 9, but if you only take one point away from this entire video, then take this one. I talked about the ugliness of our ego before, and that talking monkey on your shoulder is never more prevalent than every time you miss a shot with the Peacekeeper or your longbow hits the side of a mountain. You hear the same voice every time, and that is the one that comes after each of those misses, and it speaks to you saying the same thing. Dickhead. Now, whilst some would argue that this is fire for the furnace to improve, and you know, you defy that voice, and those who argue that, they're the ones who are so hungry for success, and they're going to be the best at what they do, and they're going to be the king of the jungle in whatever they do. And newsflash though, you're shite. You're a loser. You don't have that kind of time. You're not dedicating your life to Apex Legends. So when that voice shouts dickhead at you, doubt is creeping in. And perhaps, let's face it, that voice is probably right. What we got to do is quieten that voice, because listening to it breeds pressure, and pressure is self-made. So when you fail at your shots, fail better until you hit your mark, and spank that just ignore it, right? Number 10. When a video is 10 minutes long, it no longer matters what I have to say, because I don't care. Why don't you just make your farts into glitter?